My answer to your question is that I don't know exactly what we can or can't do, but we would sit back just like we did last time. I'm not going to lay out, sit here and tell you we're going to do this, we're going to do that. I need to look at it, sit down with the team, and see what we can do, if anything. And that's my answer. Like I said in the opening statement, willing to open the doors, new people come over, city council will be there, we'll sit down, we'll hash this out. I know you guys have some weight limits here on your roads, width of your roads, so we have to take this all into respect, and I'm sure the city and Shadow Lakes can come to an agreement, and some of your tax dollars will be back to you.
Hank?
I'm Hank. I'm one of the board members of Shadow Lakes, and I'm the maintenance department. Now, I got Danny over there. When I need him, he's there for us so far this year. Since he's been on the board, he's been for us. Jim Hutton, he's there right away. We have a sewer problem. We need that truck. He's out here. We had a sewer problem the other day. We called Jim. Jim had the truck out here, and in 45 minutes he was out here helping us to fix our water problem. I have no problem with these guys. There's a little thing that we're going to talk about, whoever comes mayor, on certain things that we're paying for that I don't think we should be paying for. But I don't want to bring it up now. We'll wait till it. We have a meeting on whoever comes mayor and that there and have that. But these two guys, I have no problem with them. They've helped Shadow Lake for great. I think they're great guys. Thank you.
Anybody have a question?
It could be for whoever could answer it. It's about the roads. I've heard from people that you don't want to raise taxes, and that I've also heard that there's very little money to fix roads, but that everybody agrees that the roads are bad. How do you intend to get the money to start fixing the roads in Braidwood at a faster rate?
I'll take it. We have different funding sources. We have MFT, which is the motor fuel tax. What that is every time you buy gas in Braidwood, I'll use just round numbers for clarification. Let's say 5 cents per gallon goes into a fund. At the end of the year, it goes into the motor fuel tax fund. At the end of the year, the state will send me a letter saying you accumulated, say, $100,000. That has to be used for fixing of roads, purchasing equipment. It has to be earmarked very, very specifically for what it's used for. I have been using it mostly for fixing our roads. That's one avenue of funding. Another avenue of funding is our general budget, which, as we know, unfortunately, with the state portion of which we count on, has been cut. That is due to no fault of this board. If the state cuts us, there's nothing we can do. So we have to try to get the most bang for the buck. So what our board is trying to do is, number one, entertain low bids, which by law we are required to do, but number two, try to consolidate the bids. You have to have a priority list. Which road is the worst? Which road needs to be done? Traffic studies. There's so much that has to be implemented into it. Unfortunately, the amount of roads and streets to be fixed is here, the funding level is down there. And without a priority list, not everything can be done. That's why a main arterial like Novi was first on the list. We did a traffic study. Chief Durant put the counter out there, the rubber hose across the road. That's why that speed limit is 40. Center Street is 25. that has 5 to 6 times the cars on Novi Road as does Center Street. So that's a main arterial for north-south. That's why that was done first. That's why I'm saying you have to prioritize what you have to get done. You know, so do I wish I had money? Of course. We just, unfortunately, you just have to make your, you know, you have to pick your battles, and it, I just wish I had the money for it. You know, that's the avenues of funding, and that's what we have to live with.